Lord is coming, are you ready?
Good morning, everyone. This is 287. And to those who are keeping the Sabbath today, I hope you're having a happy and blessed Sabbath. Now, today I'm going to spend a couple minutes talking about living in the world. We all know that living in this world is not an easy thing, especially if you're trying to live your life a particular way, be it good or bad. However you're trying to live your life, this world doesn't make it easy. Now, if you're trying to live your life according to the word of the Father, we have to understand that this is where we are tried in the fire. This is where we are proven to the word of the Father and to the Father himself. We have to go through trials and tribulations that the word tells us that we're going to go through, because we have to prove ourselves to him. If it were easy, there'd be no point in anyone going through anything. We'd all just be swooped up and taken to heaven. But that's not the case, because people can lie and deceive just as soon as they open their mouth and show you in their ways that they're not who they think they are or who we perceive them to be. But the Father knows, so he allows us to be tried over and over again. Our faith has to be tested. So one thing about living in the world is we have to figure out and learn how to live in this world, which we have no choice but do, but yet not be of this same world. We can separate ourselves from this world. Now, that doesn't mean isolate yourself by going living up in the hills and the mountains and fortifying yourself in some kind of log cabin or fortress or what have you. That creates all sorts of worldly problems. We have to learn how to walk in the midst of the enemy and survive, but there are certain things we should and shouldn't do to help our cause. So with that being said, I'm going to read Titus 2:11 and verse 12. Now, 2:11 reads, "For the grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared to all men." And that's true, it has. To those who were alive then when the Savior himself appeared, he was that salvation. He taught that salvation to them. He revealed his plan of righteousness and everything that we needed to those who are alive, and it's been preserved in the Word. So it has been revealed to all men. We have to understand that. We have to study it. We have to live it. We have to breathe it. We have to eat it. Now, verse 12 reads, "Teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lust, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world." So we have to do it right in this world amidst all the chaos and temptation that there is. We have to do it in this world. And how do we do that? We do that through the Word, through studying the Word, through living the Word. This is what will get us through. We're taught all the things we need to know through the Word. So we have to live according to that and follow its, quote unquote, its laws, its guidance, its rules, and all these things, so that we may be proven to the Father worthy when he comes back. So with that being said, in the next part, we're going to talk about some things that are really important in terms of where we should be living or shouldn't be living, and some things we have to do or should be doing to help our cause in staying on track in living the Word, because we can't live in the midst of the lion literally and think that we're going to survive. We can live in this world, but there are places and things we should and shouldn't be around to help our cause so that we may stay on track living the Father's Word. So with that being said, keep in mind the Heavenly Father didn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is 287. I'm out.
Thank you.